Alright, well, we have Sam. Welcome, Sam. He's in the pad. We made it.
We're in the pad. We made it, brother.
Yeah, man.
We've made it.
We made it. Sam and me have known each other for a very long time. He now is a coach for PA, a thriving coach. He's doing great. And he's in Bali for 6 weeks with his missus. Come out. He's always wanted to come here. And I'm feeling pretty grateful and blessed that he is here and he's able to actually travel the world and work remotely. It's absolutely insane. And my goal when I set up this business over 6 years ago was to be able to travel, work online, but also be able to give that to coaches as well, because the experience of traveling and moving around different countries and just having more freedom with that is an absolute, an amazing thing that you can do in life. So I always push my coaches to travel. We've got three other coaches in Dubai at the moment who have just landed the other day. A few of them went to Spain the other month, which is epic. So I'm trying to push these guys to experience different things. I know you've been wanting to come to Bali for a long time anyway, and before he got the job with me, he worked in the same warehouse that I worked in, my brother worked in, Jamie worked in, Dan worked in. So that means there's five people who are now on the PA team, who are local lads working
within the business.
Local Bolton B-town massive lads. So I feel fucking sick. We're winning, baby.
We're winning. We're grateful.
We're winning. And I know, well, you were working at the job that I worked at as well, and I experienced that job role, and we didn't get treated well, did we, bro?
No, not at all.
We didn't get treated well. We're not going to name any names, but we weren't treated well. We were looked down upon. And the way we were worked was very, like,
disrespectful. No respect.
No respect.
No respect. Not for anything you did for them. Absolutely nothing.
Yeah, and because I've had different jobs in the past before, where I've experienced bad managers and people who are head of the business and they treat you like shit, and I'm just like, fuck, you know what, when I actually build this, I knew I was going to build it, I am going to make sure I look after people as much as I can and give people opportunities to grow within the business, have more freedom and make more money, and just look after them. That's number one. And if you look after your team, they'll look after you, and it's that respect thing. But like, look how far you've come, bro. It's absolutely amazing. Like, you're getting amazing results with clients, some of the best results we've seen. He's having people message him direct as well now, wanting to work with him, which is a game changer. But like, how has your life changed before he jumped on board?
Oh man, it's changed big time. I remember the first time we spoke on the phone.
Yeah.
Before I actually came on board at Physique Academy, and I was speaking to you about where I was kind of up to within myself mentally, and knowing that I needed to get out of where I was,
yeah,
get out of that position, get out of working for people or giving my energy and just giving everything to a place that, of course, wasn't where I wanted to be forever. We don't want to work in a warehouse, and we don't want to work for people who don't respect the energy we give them.
It's not disrespectful to anyone out there who's working in work. It's not saying that.
It's the people you work for. And I remember even speaking to the bosses at the company and just saying, you know, trying to bring awareness to them about the staff turnover there.
Yeah.
You know, I was there for 4 years, and the amount of people who came and went in that time was actually incredible. I met so many different people.
Yeah.
You know, people come a couple of minutes later, be gone. New people in, new people out, new people in, leaving. So across the space of 4 or 5 years, I met a lot of you know, different people, and I try to bring that to their awareness, because, you know, I always was working on myself throughout that time. You know,
yeah, you're still in the gym, right?
I was training, don't get me wrong, I was always training in the gym, you know, 6-7 times a week. I've always trained since I've been, you know, 15, 16 years old. I've been a very disciplined, you know, guy within myself. And I, you know, came to a point where I became the warehouse manager at their place, and I knew this isn't going to work.
No.
This just isn't going to work unless these guys change their attitude to staff and their attitude to how they treat me. But they didn't want to listen to that. Yeah. That's why when we first had our call and I spoke to you about that, and I listened to the way you spoke and I listened to the way you were building the team and the way you had this vision of what it is to not be a boss but be a leader, still have that, you know, that control, still have that drive, but come across in a way that's gonna motivate the team around you rather than bring them down.
Yeah, I appreciate that, bro. We're not just trying to film this video just to try and chat some bullshit. Like, the team is thriving and the energy in the team is good. Like, I've not had any coaches want to leave or any shit really happen since we started it so far. So it's good, we're blessed, and I wanted to kind of bring Sam on here just because his transformation as well, mentally, going from where he was at to now being a PA coach, and that is a fucking hard thing. Like, I have some unbelievable standards and you have to uphold them. And you can't come on the team if you don't hit those standards or want to try and get to that standard. You won't be on board. It's as simple as that. I don't accept anything less than the best. And he's dealt with that, and now he's earning great money. He's able to travel. He actually wakes up in the morning and feels fucking good about himself and his life. And things can change very quick. Very quick, can't it?
Very quick. Hard work, though. Hard work.
It's hard.
I mean, don't get me wrong, it was hard. And I mean, even from the start, and I'll own up to all my mistakes, and I'm never someone to, you know, claim that I'm perfect with anything that I do. And I know from the start, you know, everyone's gonna make some mistakes. Yeah. And when I made those mistakes, you know, you told me straight, you know, told me this isn't good enough, this is not the standard of Physique Academy. And of course, that then comes down to, you know, me and how do I take that on board, you know, because I knew you as a person, because, you know, we had our calls, you know, I got to know you, I was like, George isn't coming at me in a bad way here, he has his standards. If I want to be the best person I can be and do well for him and do well for myself and do well for the company and grow with the vision and philosophy of what we've got, then I've got to be true to those standards. And that's what you've instilled in me, and that is, you know, that's what I'm grateful for, because it's made me the coach I am today. You know, it's given me the opportunity to be the coach I am today, and like you say, you know, changing lives, literally changing lives. And it's an amazing thing, it's an amazing opportunity.
Respect, bro. Yeah, this is it, guys. Like, it's all about the clients, it's not about us. Like, I've got my own goals, Sam's got his own goals, but we need to work together as a team to accomplish what we want out of life. And I'm not just gonna shout and scream about what I want out of life. It's not about that. It's like, Sam, what do you want out of this? How far do you wanna go? What opportunities do you want? Well, if you work hard, you can get this, you can have that. You'll be able to have more respect, have more opportunities within the brand, because the sky is the limit with this, and we're forever evolving, and there's so many different roles to play and opportunity to grow within the business and to have more responsibility. So yeah, man, that's it. We get it, we dominate. Let's blow this bitch up, and we're gonna go hit a workout at Wonderlust, because Sam is a very, very athletic and fit individual. He is very fit. I like him as well because he's very composed. He's not like me or some of the other guys who just, you know, have a little bit of more of an ego. Do you know what I mean? He just keeps himself to himself. He just grinds it out and he gets shit done.
Get it done.
And he fucking shows the big dogs that he's not here to play.
We love getting sweaty.
We're gonna be sweating. We're gonna be dripping. So yeah, man.
Let's do it, brother.
some DB ball over shoulder. Yeah.
Yeah. So we're working with one exercise at a time.
I'll talk about the work after.
Yeah.
When we're done.
Yeah, but talk about it to me before we do it.
If we get the workout done before all the calories are finished, then we work as a three getting through them. You know what I mean? You gotta be strategic with it. So the toes to bar, the first three sets, two sets, I might do 15 reps. He might do 15 reps. You might do 15 the first set, then 10 the second one. Then it's 10, 10, 10, maybe it's 5, 5, 5 to get through it, to get to 150.
Remember back in the day when you taught me to live and I taught you to pray. We went in the battle together, no matter the weather, we never delayed. You gave me commands, I always obeyed. I never let you go astray. I never thought I'd see the day that you would come and just betray me. Sick of playing silly games, you never loved me anyway. You should not have let me get away, cause now I'm hunting for my prey. I'm bigger, I'm better, my mind is a weapon. I won't ever let up, you try to break me down and I'ma just get up. They ask me how I did it, I'ma just tell them I rose up. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life. Coming back stronger. I will arrive. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life. Coming back stronger. I will arise. Staring at you from afar, analyzing every scar. Asking myself how we got here. Remember, this is who we are. I am not here for revenge. I did not come to make amends. Not here to repent for my sins. I just came here to win. I just came here to end. I just came here to fight. Show you everything you said I couldn't be. I became overnight. This for the blood, this is for the tears. This is for my pain and my plight. Two walked in, but only one of us is walking out of here tonight. I'm a survivor. For my life, coming back stronger. I will arise. I'm a survivor. Fight for my life, coming back stronger. I will arise.
Oh, patience. You're gonna fucking go. We have to fucking win. Go, 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 come on.
Get it up.
Fucking short. Fucking short. Show them what you're about. Get out. Get out. Come on. Now go, go, go. Come on.
Yo, yo, yo. What's up? Just woke up, guys. It's 9 a.m. That's a late one for us. This is a weekend. So I think at the weekends, we're trying to accumulate a little bit more sleep for the week ahead. Yesterday's workout was an absolute savage beatdown. You know what? I actually felt really, really good because the boys were keeled over on the floor and I was all right for once, but I think you caught me on a good day. But yeah, after a fucking hard workout, there's nothing better for me because that sense of accomplishment is just absolutely insane. And you can't push yourself every single day like that. I've tried. It's not just taxing your body, but it's more so mentally taxing on your body. You feel it like emotionally, that stress on your CNS and just putting like all the cards on the table and going 100 mile an hour into the workout is mentally taxing. So that was a beautiful, beautiful workout. We didn't end up filming anything or talking about it. And what it was is it was in a three, so an accumulation of 500 calories on the assault bike. So someone's pretty much always on the assault bike. We were trying to hit 65 RPM just continuously to just keep it going. And we did 150 toes to bar, 150 hand cleans, 75 dumbbell burpee box step ups, 150 sumo high pulls, 75 dumbbell DP ball to shoulder. Sorry guys, it's early.
And then when you're working through it, what you're basically doing is someone's always on the assault bike, but you're changing around. So you're basically changing, like one of you is always resting, one of you is doing the actual exercise, whether it's barbell, toes to the bar, dumbbell, box step up, and you're just trying to basically pace yourself and go as fast as possible and be really kind of efficient in your changes of each exercise. So yeah, and then because we got to the end of it and there was still 120 calories left, we then jumped on the assault bike together and pretty much just sent it, Reese, me, Sam, rotating around to get to 500 calories on the assault bike. It was a good workout. What time did I actually get for that workout? Fuck, I don't know. We'll put it on the screen, yeah, what time I actually got and try and compete with that, guys. In a 3, don't cheat, we used 17.5 dumbbells and we used 50 kilos on the barbell. But yeah, like at the moment, I'm trying to really kind of make sure I'm resting and recovering because I've not been looking after myself as I should be. So more sleep, more rest, coming outside, grounding, reflecting, just chilling out and not waking up and just fucking straight into work. So times have changed and today's gonna be more of a chilled day. I'm gonna have a couple of days off, to be honest. I felt pretty fatigued mentally again, just from a lot of work. There's some big changes going on in the business and I feel like sometimes I get so hands-on in with trying to do everything and trying to oversee everything that mentally it just fucking gets to me. So a few days off from work, pulling back, reevaluating, realigning, and then going again bigger, faster, stronger. Let's get it.